गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, वी वर रीडिंग लेसन नंबर 14 एंड लेसन नंबर 14 वाज द नेशनलिस्ट मूवमेंट. इन दैट लेसन सो फार आई हैव टॉट यू अबाउट फॉर्मेशन ऑफ इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस. इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस प्रेजेंटली ऑल्सो इट इज नोन एज कांग्रेस पार्टी एंड मिसेस सोनिया गांधी इज द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ दिस पार्टी. Then I told you that Congress, Indian National Congress was formed in 1885 and it was divided on its policy or action between moderates and the radicals. Split took place in Congress in the year 1917 and again Congress party was reunited in 1916 in the Lucknow session of Congress and they jointly signed Lucknow Pact in 1916. We have also read about partition of Bengal in this lesson. Lord Curzon partitioned in 1905 to divide the unity between Hindus and Muslims. Now, formation of Muslim League also we have read in 1906 it was formed. Then Britishers started trying to appease to satisfy the Indians through some reforms and that reform was known as Morley-Minto reform. Home Rule League was established in 1916 by an Irish lady and that lady was Mrs. Amy Besant, which started Home Rule League movement in Madras and in Maharashtra. It was started by Bal Gangadhar Tilak. Now today we have to read about arrival of Mahatma Gandhi in our Indian politics, in our Indian nationalist movement. Children, we all know Mahatma Gandhi's role is too much, is very big in our nationalist movement. So, after the First World War was fought between the years 1914 to 1918. Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, full name of Mahatma Gandhi was Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, took over the leadership of the Congress. He introduced the technique of non-violent. Non-violent means not to kill anyone without any violence. And this technique was known as Satyagraha. Satyagraha means Satya ke liye agraha, fight for the truth and demand for truth. It was a non-violent struggle against the British oppression. Mahatma Gandhi propagated what? Tolerance, brotherhood, non-violence and simple living. Gandhiji realized that social reforms were necessary for a truly national struggle. We all know, children, that at that time, so many social evils were prevalent in our society. And Gandhiji realized that to achieve national independence, to achieve national struggle, first society should be reformed. And he established Sabarmati Ashram in Gujarat, where people of all castes and religions were welcome. And his first movement, Mahatma Gandhi's first movement, was supported by peasant. And where? In Champaran district of Bihar. It's a matter of great pride for all the Biharis that Gandhiji started his first movement in Bihar only, and that was known as Champaran Satyagraha. And here he forced the British government to increase the price of indigo. Indigo is the blue dye which the people use to color, to shine, to brighten the white clothes for the benefit of the peasants. And by 1919, Gandhiji had become the most popular leader of India and he launched many mass movements. Although his first satyagraha was at Champaran, But after that, he did not stop, and many mass movements means in which the people of whole country, they joined together. And then what I had told you, Britishers started satisfying the Indians. For that they introduced Morley Minto reforms in 1909, and now they introduced Montague James Fort reforms. Montague James Fort reforms were introduced in which year? 1919. The British paid no heed to the agitation for self-rule. What was the demand of the Indians? Self-rule. But Britishers did not do anything for self-rule. Going on all over the country, they introduced another set of reforms to appease people. Appease people means to satisfy the people. People of which country we are talking? People of India. But the reforms were insignificant. It was not important for the Indians. The number of elected members was increased in Legislative Assembly. In this reform, elected members were increased in Legislative Assembly and Council of States, but there was no change in the location of power. Location of power means power was located to whom? To the Britishers. It was not given to the Indians. And the system of dual government in this reform, dual government was introduced. That dual government, dyarchy system was introduced, and all important subjects like finance and police were under the control of the governor, and the Indian ministers were given the charge of education and health in this dyarchy system. But the real power still remained with the British officials. Indians were again very disappointed with these reforms. And then Britishers introduced Rowlatt Act. It was in fact a black law for the Indians. There was growing unrest among Indians and protest increased. So the British government passed which act? Rowlatt Act, to consolidate their control. And what was in this Rowlatt Act? It empowered the government to arrest anyone without a warrant. You just think, children, it is illegal to arrest anyone without warrant. But with this Rowlatt Act, Britishers introduced this Rowlatt Act, and with this one law was made to arrest anyone without any warrant. Warrant is needed for arresting anyone. And imprison people without trial, means without any listening, without listening his points. This Rowlatt Act gave the Britishers power to arrest anyone and imprison people without trial. And trial, this caused massive demonstrations and hartals all over the country. This Rowlatt Act was also known as Black Law, as no arrested person was allowed to go for an appeal, daleel or vakil. Means in this Rowlatt Act, no appeal was there. No one can appeal to anyone. No daleel was there. No one can argue himself against this, that why this act was introduced and why he has been arrested. Then there was no vakil for this act. Means Rowlatt Act was a black law. In it, no appeal, no daleel, no vakil was there. Then a very famous black day of Indian history, when Jallianwala Bagh massacre took place. And where Jallianwala Bagh massacre, you must have heard, children, about
Jallianwala Bagh incident. I have told you this Rowlatt Act was introduced by the Britishers in 1919, and according to it, what was there? Anyone could be arrested without any warrant, and he could be imprisoned without trial. No appeal, no vakil, no daleel. So you just think, children, it was good or bad? It was not good. And that's why a peaceful protest was going on the day of Baisakhi on 13th April 1919. It was the day of Baisakhi. Baisakhi is a very famous festival of Punjabi people. And where this Jallianwala Bagh is located? At Amritsar in Punjab. And at Amritsar, a peaceful protest was going on the day of Baisakhi, that was 13th April 1919, when General Dyer ordered to fire on innocent people. And there was a narrow gate. More than 1,000 people were there in that Bagh, in that peaceful protest. And there was a narrow escape. People could not escape. They could not run away. And thousands of people were killed in this Jallianwala Bagh massacre. On April 13, 1919, the people of Punjab gathered, and that was when they gathered on the auspicious day of Baisakhi at Jallianwala Bagh near Golden Temple. You must have heard the name of Golden Temple in Amritsar. When they were protesting peacefully against the arrest of two prominent Congress leaders. And who were those two prominent Congress leaders? Dr. Satyapal and Saifuddin Kichlu. And General Dyer ordered the British armed force to open fire at the hundreds of innocent, unarmed men, women and children. The massacre stunned the whole country. Whole country was shocked with this incident. And the government imposed martial law in Punjab. Under martial law, people were tortured, newspapers were banned, and mails were censored. Means media could not publish anything against the government. Then non-cooperation movement was started by Mahatma Gandhi in 1921. Non-cooperation movement was started. Mahatma Gandhi said, the British rule was established and survived in India with the cooperation of Indians. And if Indians refused to cooperate, British rule would collapse and Swaraj would come. The Swaraj was the main demand of the Indians. The Congress session at Nagpur in December 20. In December 20, Congress session was in Nagpur, and that ratified Gandhiji's call for non-cooperation movement. Non-cooperation movement means, you can just understand the meaning. Non-cooperation, not to cooperate with the Britishers. Because Gandhiji realized that British rule is surviving in India due to the cooperation of the British Indians. And if Indians would not cooperate the Britishers, then the British rule would collapse and Swaraj would come. Non-cooperation was directed against the injustice done by the British in Punjab and Turkey, and it began with what? Renouncing of titles and honors given by the Britishers. Means the Indian rulers, the Indian leaders, they rejected the titles and honors given by the British. Then boycott of legislatures. Those leaders started boycotting the legislatures. Then boycott of schools, colleges by students and teachers. Indian students and teachers stopped going to schools and colleges. Then opening of Jamia Millia. Jamia Millia University is very important nowadays also in Aligarh.
and it was opened that time. And Kashi Vidyapeeth, Banaras Hindu University, Jamia Millia in Aligarh and Banaras Hindu University in Banaras, that is very important, that were opened at that time only. Boycott of government offices and courts, and then bonfires of foreign goods. Indians started burning foreign goods. Hartals and strikes all over the country. And after 1919, the struggle against the British rule took the form of a mass movement. Mass movement means in which the people of whole country started joining, which involved peasants. Peasants also joined this non-cooperation movement, tribals, students, workers, traders, women, etc. And the unity between Hindus and Muslims strengthened. When the non-cooperation movement was launched, people wholeheartedly participated in it. Means people of whole country, whole India participated in non-cooperation movement. Then happened Chauri Chaura incident. You must have heard about Chauri Chaura incident. That incident is very famous in our Indian history. Chauri Chaura incident. What happened in Chauri Chaura? In 1922, the police fired upon a group of demonstrators at Chauri Chaura in Uttar Pradesh, and the agitated mob set police station on fire. When people, British police opened fire in Chauri Chaura near Gorakhpur district in UP, then the agitated mob, the angry Indians, they opened fire. They burnt the police station in Chauri Chaura, where 22 policemen, which policemen? British policemen. 22 British policemen were burnt alive. And Gandhiji was shocked with this, because Gandhiji's first thing was not to adopt any violent activities. And Indians adopted this violent activity. Why did the Indians adopt this violent activity? Because in Chauri Chaura, British policemen opened fire. So the angry Indians, they burnt that police station in which 22 British policemen were burnt alive. Gandhiji was shocked and he called off the non-cooperation movement, as he felt that the movement had lost its non-violent character. Some leaders supported his decisions, but leaders like Jawaharlal Nehru and Subhas Chandra Bose opposed the withdrawal of the movement due to one violent incident. When Gandhiji withdrew this non-cooperation movement, well, the movement was on its peak. So many leaders were unhappy. Motilal Nehru and Chittaranjan Das formed Swaraj Party to enter the legislative councils and then destroy the British administration from inside. Because they were in this thinking that they can destroy the British government by entering in it. From outside, they could not do it. So they thought that we should enter in the British governance and then we can destroy it. In spite of single-handedly stopping the non-cooperation movement, Gandhiji was arrested. Gandhiji was arrested by whom? By the Britishers. Though the non-cooperation movement was withdrawn prematurely, means before time only, it was successful in bringing the entire country close and helped in giving a national character to the country's freedom struggle. It was the first mass movement. Non-cooperation movement was the first mass movement of Gandhiji. Gandhiji continued to propagate Khadi, Hindu-Muslim unity and eradication of untouchability. Untouchability means he gave a new word to those untouchables. people of upper caste were not in need, they did not like to touch the people of lower caste. So Gandhiji gave a new name to them, Harijan. Hari means God, Jan means people, means God's people. Then the peasants and workers joined the freedom movement to oppose British exploitation and high taxes. Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel took up the cause of peasants in Bardoli in Gujarat. Now we have to read about the another major incident of our national movement, that is Simon Commission. Simon Commission, in which year? In 1927. Simon Commission was sent to India to review the Government of India Act 1919. I have told you Montague Chelmsford reform was introduced by the government. So Simon Commission was sent to India to review this act and suggest further reforms to appease the Indians, to satisfy the Indians. Congress decided to oppose the commission because no Indian was there in this commission. It did not have even a single Indian representatives. Wherever Simon Commission went, it was boycotted by the Congress. On Bombay Airport, black flags were shown. Go back, Simon. Simon, John Simon was the head of this commission. On his name only, Simon Commission is there. And people welcomed them with black flag and go back, Simon, go back. This slogan was raised. Because no Indian was there in 7 members committee, then it was understood that the committee will not write in favor of India. And that's why it was opposed. Congress as well as the Muslim League with black flags, they boycotted it. Lala Lajpat Rai was seriously injured while protesting in a police lathi charge in Lahore, and he later died also to his injuries. Then the very important session of Congress, that is Lahore session of Congress in 1929. Children, I have told you that if you watch KBC, which is being telecasted these days, then so many questions are being asked from your this lesson only. Once again, once in previous KBC session, 2 years before, in that KBC season, the question was asked, that it was 50 lakhs question, and it was asked, who was the chairman of, president of Lahore session of Congress in 1929? And the contestant who was sitting on so hot a seat, he could not give answer. What will be the answer? Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. The correct answer was Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, and this question was of 50 lakhs. So just you think, children, how interesting this lesson is. So, in December 1929, the Congress session was held on the bank of River Ravi in Lahore with Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru as president. And the historic resolution of Purna Swaraj, now Congress leaders started demanding about not only Swaraj, but complete independence, that was called in Hindi Purna Swaraj. They started demanding it, and that's why this Lahore session of Congress is very important in our Indian history, because they started demanding about Purna Swaraj. Then they also started, they also decided to launch civil disobedience movement. Earlier, which movement was started by Mahatma Gandhi? Non-cooperation movement. And then civil disobedience movement was decided to launch. It was decided to celebrate January 26, 1930 as the first Independence Day of India. And as per the resolution of after the Lahore session in 1929, it was decided to celebrate January 26, 1930 as first Independence Day of India. One question may arise, children, that India got freedom on which date? 15th August 1947. Then why our constitution was imposed on January 26th? Why not on 15th August? And the reason for this is that in Lahore session of 1929, Congress leaders decided to observe next January 26, 1930 as their first Independence Day. They observed it, and from 1930 to 1947, every year this January 26th was celebrated as Independence Day of India. But India got freedom on which date? 15th August. So to mark the importance of this day, which date? January 26th. Our constitution was enforced on January 26th. So you see, children, this Lahore session of Congress of 1929, three decisions were taken, and those three decisions were very important in India's freedom struggle, in the nationalist movement of India. And those three decisions were, first one was demand for complete independence, second one was to observe January 26, 1930 as their first Independence Day, and the third one was to launch civil disobedience movement. This question is very important. Many times they have asked in the exam. So you just see it, this Lahore session of Congress was very important. And as per the resolution, after the Lahore session in 1929, January 26th was celebrated as Independence Day every year. The Constitution of India was completed on November 26, 1949 itself. But it was decided to adopt and enforced on January 26, 1950 in the memory of January 26, 1930. And according to the Constitution of India, since then we celebrate January 26 as Republic Day every year. So I think you must have understood about Lahore session of Congress. And now about civil disobedience movement. What I told you, civil disobedience movement, in which year it was started? In Lahore session, the leaders decided to start it, and it was started civil disobedience movement. From 1930 to 1934. Salt, we all know, just imagine if your food is without salt, then will there be any taste? No. So salt is the basic requirement for every person. And what Britishers did, they put a ban on salt making, that only Britishers could make the salt. And salt was the basic need for any common man. So oppose this salt law, civil disobedience movement was started by Mahatma Gandhi. And the British government had a monopoly on salt production, and it passed a law banning manufacturing of salt law by any Indian, so that the British could sell salt at high rates. And the salt made in Liverpool in England would not face any competition. That's why British government put a ban on it. So on March 12, 1930, Mahatma Gandhi began his epic Dandi March. You must have heard about Dandi March. And that is how the march came to be. It was started at the coastal area of Dandi. It was started from Sabarmati. Gandhi ji with his delegates went to Dandi and then picked up a handful of salt and broke salt law. And that's why this epic march is known as Dandi March. He was accompanied by, Gandhi ji was accompanied by 78 supporters. They made salt from seawater and broke the salt law. And salt satyagraha, this movement is also known as salt satyagraha, was an open challenge to the British and the civil disobedience movement spread all over the country, and it became the second mass movement. First mass movement, I have told you, non-cooperation movement was the first mass movement, and civil disobedience movement was the second mass movement. And mass movement means you must be knowing, in which the people of whole country joined and they participated in it. And after that, children, we will read about Quit India movement. And Quit India movement was the last mass movement, and after that it gave a final blow to the British government. And after that, Gandhiji did not need to launch any mass movement, because in 1947 we got independence. And Gandhiji, this movement was led by in Northwest Frontier Provinces. This civil disobedience movement was led by Khan Abdul Ghaffar Khan. And Khan Abdul Ghaffar Khan is also known as Frontier Gandhi. What Gandhiji did in our country, Khan Abdul Ghaffar Khan did in that side, in Pakistan side, Northwest Frontier Provinces. And the British government tried to repress the movement as usual and resorted to violence. Thousands of protesters were arrested, including Gandhiji and Jawaharlal Nehru also. But what happened? A feeling of patriotism, a feeling of nationalism, a feeling of to get complete independence was spread in all the country, and this movement united the people in all over the country. So today, this much only, children. The civil disobedience movement we have read. We have read non-cooperation movement also. We have read about Rowlatt Act. We have read about Simon Commission, the Lahore session of Congress. Today, this much only. And your homework for today is to read this lesson. In our next class, this lesson will be completed, and then I will give you question answers. So that's all for today. Goodbye and thank you.